What is black? Our art teacher told us it's the absence of color opposed to an actual color, but what does that mean? And why are there so many variations? Tricorn black, caviar, green black? Well, we have the black to end all blacks. But before we get to black, let's talk color. What is it? Color is our perception of different wavelengths of light. Humans could only see a limited amount of the spectrum. Just ask the mantis shrimp about this as they laugh at our ability to see a mere 10 million colors while they can see, well, more than that. Color, me jealous of food. Anyway, light travels in packets called photons. When photons with a wavelength of about 650 nanometers hit your eye, you see red. 570 nanometers is a yellow-green and 480 nanometers is blue. When photons of all different wavelengths hit your eye, you see white. Now, pigment molecules are what makes something a certain color. This happens because pigments absorb certain wavelengths of light and reflect others. So when light shines on an object, the wavelength of light in the object reflects back towards your eyes, corresponding to the color you see. Take the skin of an orange. It absorbs red, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet photons, but reflects orange photons. And then there's black. So let's say you're looking at a metalhead's t-shirt. You see the material that absorbs all wavelengths of the visible light. Well, almost all of them. Your brain registers the t-shirt as black, but the shirt is still reflecting some photons. Similarly, black paints absorb between 90 and 95% of the light that hits them, which is pretty good. The aerospace industry has a black paint called Aeroglaze Z306 that absorbs about 96% of light. It's used to coat the insides of big telescopes so that detectors can pick up even the dimmest light from distant galaxies. But to get the blackest black, we need to use nanotechnology. Researchers are using arrays of carbon nanotubes to trap photons. Photons that hit the surface get trapped among the nanotubes and bounce around until they lose their energy and turn into not light, or as we'd like to call it in science, heat. At this point, there's some debate over whose black is the blackest. NASA has a carbon nanotube coating that absorbs 99.95% of the light that hits it, making it a candidate to replace the Z306 in telescopes. Another contender is called Vantablack, whose makers say it can absorb 99.965% of the light that hits it. That's over 100 times blacker than Z306. The Vanta stands for Vertically Aligned Carbon Nanotube Arrays. Whether it's NASA's Super Black or Vantablack, the stuff is so black, when it's painted on something like aluminum foil, it looks more like a hole than a coating. To your brain, all around the Vantablack is stuff, so what's in between must be non-stuff. You just see nothing, the ultimate black. Well, almost. If you want to get true black, there's only one place to go, a real black hole. Black holes absorb all the light and everything else, so maybe actually you shouldn't go there. Okay, well, thanks for putting your eyes at these photons. Be sure to let us know what your favorite color is in the comments right down there below, or hit us up on Facebook or Twitter. We'll see you next time, unless you're coated in Vantablack or NASA Super Black, but anyway, thanks for watching.